Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can join two different clips that was generated using the LTX video generator and how you can generate longer videos. So let's take a look at this example here. As you can see, it is 8 seconds long. And it appears to be a continuous shot, but just around here is where the first clip ends and then LTX video generates a second clip that continues it. So if I go into this video editor here, you can see that I have the first clip here and then the second clip here. And you can see the name is different. It's this one is ComfyUI 10. This one is ComfyUI 12. I made a mistake in between, so let's not look at 11. But if I go and scroll through frame by frame, you can see that LTX video, well, the quality is pretty good. But once we reach here, that is the end of the first clip. And then right away, it continues it. So if I join these two together, and you can see how smooth the transition is like this. I have a few more examples here. So let's take a look at this clip. This is the first clip and we just have a paper plane flying in a room and this is the end frame basically. So the paper plane is stationary here. Now, if I go into the next clip here, 5, you can see I'm starting the clip and it's the same thing, but now the camera is shifting to a different shot. And that is based on the prompt. I could have made the paper plane go longer. And I have another one here. So here's one where I've just continued the shot from the first clip. So first clip, the paper plane is stationary and it continues into a second paper plane like this. So you can continue the shot. You can change the shot completely like I've done. And the transition will be smooth like this. So this is what we are going to learn to do inside of ComfyUI. In the description of this video, you will get a link that will take you to GitHub and you will get these three files here, number 1, 2, and 3. Simply drag the first one into ComfyUI, let go, and it will open up the workflow. Now, this is an LTX video workflow. I've already made a video explaining how to download these models, but just in case you don't have it, you will need to download the LTX video 2B. And at the time that I made that last video on LTX, the model version was 0.9.0. Now, we have an update where the model version is 0.9.1. So you will need to download the latest version in order to use this trick that I'm about to show you. Now, you will also need to have a clip. This clip is the same as the Flux. You can also download the Google T5 clip if you want. I will have all the links in the description below, so you can click on it and download it. Make sure that once you've downloaded it, this LTX video one, you place it inside the ComfyUI models checkpoint folder, and then this one inside the clip folder. Once you've done that, go into edit, refresh node definition, and then select it from here. Okay, so this is the workflow for the first shot. And make sure that you have your models. The only thing that you will do here is change the prompt here. The LTX video requires a good prompt. It requires quite elaborate. So you will need to add a descriptive prompt here. You can ask ChatGPT to generate the prompt for you and then copy and paste it here. Then what you need to make sure here is that the width and height is what it is here. So 768 by 512. You can go higher, but based on the project page, it says that this is the optimal resolution. And then you will get your generated video here. As you can see, this is just the first clip. Now to continue the shot, you will need the second workflow, number 2. So drag the second one into ComfyUI, let go, and you can see that this one we have a little bit more. Let's start from the top left. You will see that we have a load video upload, and this one will take in the previous clip. So click on choose video to upload and then simply navigate to where you have ComfyUI installed. Go into the outputs folder and you will see all the videos that you've generated using the first workflow. So I'm going to select this one, click on open, and you can see I have that clip there. Now leave everything as is and scroll over to where we have the text prompt. This is where you will describe the second scene or the second shot. It can be a continuation of the first one. So this was the prompt that I've used for the first one. So I can leave the prompt as is. For you, you can copy your prompt, paste it here, or you can add new elements to this. So it's again the same model that you're using and you will select your clip. Now in this particular case, I'm just continuing the shot. So I still have the paper plane flying inside a room. When we look at the result, you will see that it's going to continue the shot. That is because the prompt here is just continuing the shot. If you have different elements in your scene, then describe it in your prompt and it will appear here. So this is going to be clip number two. We'll go into the third workflow, which is the combining LTX video. Let's drag that inside of ComfyUI and you will see that we have two load videos now. The first one is going to be clip one. The second one is going to be clip two. So click on choose video to upload, select the first one, click on the next one and select the second one like this. And then just click on the cue prompt and you will get a final that's going to combine it and it's going to be seamless. So as you can see, this is the first shot and around here we go into the second shot and we can barely tell when is the second shot starting. All right, so let's take a look at a few examples I've done using the same method and this is the first shot, the same thing, but this time the paper plane goes into flames and then we have like a person appearing in the scene. You can do things like this as well. We're completely changing the shot, but around here where the flames start is when that second clip is starting and you can barely tell that it's two different clips that was generated separately. Here's another one where the scene changes completely. So we have a ball bouncing and then ask for smoke. Imagine and change the ball into smoke. But you can see that even the ball is changing like this into some kind of explosion, but it's still seamless. It's like morphing into that smoke that we have here. So these are the type of images that will be generated. And by using the video combine, it will basically combine it into a video that's going to be continuous. All right, so a short video. I just wanted to point out this technique that you can use. These three workflows will be available for you guys to download from GitHub. And for my Patreon members supporting the channel, you will get a workflow that is basically an all-in-one workflow. You will start from the left and you will have a prompt here that will say first scene and second scene. So you can enter your prompt here and then just click on the cue prompt. It will take care of everything. I have the preview here as disabled, but you can enable it if you want to save the individual clips. Otherwise, we go all the way here and it will save the final video here. I've also added an upscaler workflow, but as I've said here, it's very slow because it will have to do two videos. So it takes a long time. At least for me, I have only 12 gigabytes. So when I run the workflow, I'm using 100% GPU. If you have the means, consider supporting the channel on Patreon. We have exclusive workflows over there. You can simply go in and get any workflow from there. If you need additional assistance, you can join the second tier, which will also give you a video explanation of those workflows. All right then, thank you for watching until the very end. Have a nice day. Take care. I will see you next time.